morning, guys. I'm so glad that y'all joined us again this morning. This is going to be the last morning that we talk about friendships, but I want you all to continue to be good friends and always learning and pushing yourselves to be friends to people who don't have any friends and who may be on the outskirts. I know that you guys love God so much and that you want to please Him, and that is something that really makes Him happy. So today, let's read our memory verse and then sing to Him, and then let's talk about friendships.
When they had finished eating, Jesus said to Simon, "Simon, son of John, do you love me more than these?" "Yes, Lord," he said, "you know that I love you more." Jesus said, "Feed my lambs."
No shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me.
So the past few weeks, we've been learning about friendships, and we've learned that God gives us friendships for many different reasons. We talked about four friends in the New Testament who took care of their friend. They helped each other. And then we moved back to the Old Testament. We talked about friends loving one another, and when we read the story about David and Jonathan. And then we stayed in the Old Testament last week, and we learned about how important it was that friends encourage one another when we talked about Elijah and Elisha. This week, we're going to go back to the New Testament, and we're going to talk about Jesus and Peter. Now, when this story starts, I'm just going to let you know where we are. We're in the book of John, like I said, in the New Testament, and Jesus has already died on the cross. And right before that, you know that he is having dinner with his disciples, and he's trying to prepare them for what's about to happen. And he lets them know that some of them are going to run away, and some of them are going to say that they didn't even know him. Well, you might remember that Peter was just insistent that he would never deny Jesus, that he would always let anybody know that Jesus was one of his closest friends and that he was his teacher and that he loved him. You also know that Peter did exactly that. He denied Jesus whenever he thought that he might get in trouble or get arrested if he claimed that he knew him, and he was scared and ran away. So Jesus has died on the cross, and now he has come back and appeared to his disciples, but he hasn't spoken to Peter yet. He's spoken to the group and shown that he rose from the dead, and they're all very happy about it. But if you've ever done something to hurt your friend's feelings or done something to maybe that wasn't very friend-like, you might kind of know how Peter's feeling. I think he probably felt really ashamed of himself and embarrassed, and he wasn't really sure how Jesus felt about him. And so this story that we're going to read is going to show you what Jesus does to show Peter that they're still friends. Peter went fishing with some of the disciples. They fished from their boat all night, but they did not even catch one fish. Early the next morning, someone from the shore shouted, "You have not caught any fish, have you?" "No," they replied. "Cast your net to the right side of the boat," the man said. As soon as they did, their net was full of fish. Then Peter knew the man was Jesus. He jumped out of the boat and swam to shore. Jesus asked him, "Do you love me?" Peter said, "You know I do." Jesus said, "If you love me, then take good care of my people." So, how did Peter know that Jesus still wanted to be his friend? Jesus gave Peter an opportunity to tell him that he loved him. And then he gave Peter a very important job. He said, "If you love me, then take care of my people." So Peter knew that Jesus still loved him and that Jesus forgave him and that he gave him one of the most important jobs that he could think of. And that was to take care of the people that Jesus loved. The ones who knew about him and the ones who didn't know about him yet. And Peter was so thankful to be forgiven and to still be Jesus's friend that he spent the rest of his life doing exactly that. And so today I want y'all to remember that God gives us friendships to help us take care of each other, to help us love one another, to encourage each other, and also to forgive each other, because we're gonna mess up and we are gonna hurt our friends' feelings. But if we say we're sorry and if we let them know that we still wanna be friends, I'm pretty sure most of the time it's gonna work out. So, can't wait to see you guys next week. I love you so much and have a great week.